Raider Radio is the new program on Huntley Community Radio, created for and by Huntley High School students. Catch the sound for all the latest music and the talk for topics you don't want to miss.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Z-Tech Talk on Raider Radio's The Talk. I'm Zach, a.k.a. Baby Fleck Jr., and today we're starting out with something new on the show called Quick Tech. At the beginning of the show, I will fly over some smaller topics before we get into our main topic. So recently, Microsoft announced a new voice assistant similar to Siri for the Windows Phone called Cortana. New Android phones, the HTC One M8 and the Samsung Galaxy S5, were recently released, and Amazon released a new TV streaming box called the Fire TV. More topics will be added in future episodes. Today we have a very serious and life-threatening issue to talk about. It's called heartbleed. It may sound like a serious medical condition, but chances are, almost 80% of us have it. Luckily enough, this isn't a serious medical condition, but a serious internet flaw that cannot be overlooked. For those of you who may not know, when you log into a website, like Google, Yahoo, or Facebook, you log in under a protected server which is protected by a program called OpenSSL. OpenSSL encrypts all of your data so only computers know how to decode it, and a regular human is unable to. When you type in your email, name, or phone number, or even your credit card, it is safely encrypted with SSL, but it may not be that safe. OpenSSL was found to have a massive security leak that was there for the past 2 years, but nobody realized it until April of 2014. The security leak is called CVE-2014-0160, or Heartbleed. CVE stands for Common Vulnerabilities and Exposures. But why do they call it heartbleed? Well, many people have just about all of their information in websites and online. It is like your entire life is online, and online has become your heart with information about you that is being leaked or bled. Let's think about what this information is. We have websites such as Google Drive, OneDrive, or Dropbox that stores all of our data rather than storing it on our computer. We also put credit card information, names, emails, and phone numbers, and so much more on the internet. As for every website affected, someone may have any information you put into it. Sadly, however, we won't ever know if someone has taken your information. Heartbleed can be affected without any fingerprints left behind. There are many websites affected, such as Google, Yahoo, and Facebook. There are many more major websites affected as well, but there are much too many to name. Again, no one will ever know if our information was stolen from the affected sites, so I recommend you change all of your passwords. Also, if you are one of those people who uses the same password on every website, it is a good idea to change all of your passwords, even if one of the websites that you use was not affected by Heartbleed. There's a chance that someone who may have gotten your password and email address, we'll try it on other sites to see what they can get into. Overall, most websites have been fixed. If they were affected at all, there are some websites such as PayPal and ironically Target who have not been affected. The best thing you can do to prevent yourself from any issues is to change your passwords. In a technology-filled world, there are always going to be more and more people out to get you. You won't even know who they are. If you're unsure if a website you use has been affected, you can go to the website at filipo.io/heartbleed in order to test a website. You can also head over to heartbleed.com for more information on Heartbleed. So here I've got pretty much everyone from Raider Radio in this room right now, but specifically I've got Drake and Leela on the microphone right now. Do you guys have any questions?
How'd you find out about Heartbleed? Did you hear it on the news or was it like all over the internet?
Well, it was on the internet and the news, but specifically I found out about it from a website called CNET.com, which was created by CBS.
Do you think even though this was on the news and people did see it and read about it, people are actually going to go change their passwords?
It depends on how much people actually care about it. And if some people don't have all that much online, they're not too worried about it, they might just let it go. But some other people might be really worried about it and really want to change their passwords. My personal recommendation, though, is to change your passwords.
Do you think that even though this just happened recently with Target, that people are still going to be very concerned about it, especially with credit card information and banking information?
I feel like it will always be a concern with technology growing so much, and we're putting our entire lives into the internet somewhere, and we'll never actually know who's actually reading it and what we have put in there.
How do you think the school administration administration feels now that they know that this happened, and they use Google and Google Drive and all of these different websites for us to do educational things on. I mean, now they've just put students' information in jeopardy.
Well,
sticky topic, I know.
Well, personally, I think that the school should be encouraging students to change their passwords for Google, and some students refuse to use the services that the school gives us. However, if a student is using those services, the school should be pushing for them to change their passwords so the school doesn't become liable for putting that information in for the student.
So you think as a student, it would be responsible of the school to make it mandatory that everybody take a day out of class and go down to the computer lab and change their passwords?
I feel like that might actually be a really good idea, but I don't know if the school will do it.
After you heard about this, did you immediately switch your passwords on everything?
I wouldn't say immediately. I heard about it late at night one day, and I was lazy. So the next day, I ended up changing my passwords, and my new passwords now have a mixture of capital letters and lowercase letters and, you know, special characters such as exclamation points, question marks, hashtags, whatever you want, and numbers are all supposed to be in there. And to help make your passwords really secure, I recommend that everyone who hasn't changed their passwords or doesn't have a more secure password like that should change their passwords to be a more secure password. Also had a couple of questions from Mrs. Barty as well. Mrs. Barty?
Hey, Zach. Is it required, since the Heartbleed was announced, is it required by the companies or businesses like banks and like Ticketmaster, whatever, to warn the people who have the accounts and the debit card and credit card information? Or is it just a voluntary basis that's going to occur?
It's not required. I would hope if the company actually does care about their customers, I would hope that they push for their customers to change their passwords, especially like you said on banking websites where a lot of information about you is stored.
Yes, a lot of personal information. So I'm surprised none of my banks or any of my accounts that I have my personal information that I purchase online has not contacted me. And if I didn't hear it, I was probably like rest of America that, okay, maybe this is just something that's in passing. I didn't think it'd be that serious.
Well, we'll actually never know how serious it is. It's possible that no one ever actually got the information, but we'll never know because there are no fingerprints left behind.
Is this something that happened outside of the United States again, just like Target was attacked? They said that it was something, people, a group outside the United States. Is this something that we're getting targeted again from other countries?
Well, it was actually found by a security team whose job it is to try and find errors in encryption and such.
So is this at a governmental level, or is it the government that's checking this out, or just an independent consultants that are checking out, like you maybe in the future could do?
It's more the consultants instead of the actual governments. But it is happening worldwide. So whether you're in the U.S. or you're in, you know, China, it's a good idea to change your password.
Okay.
That's all we have for today on ZTech Talk here on Huntley Community Radio's Raider Radio. Tune in next time for your latest and greatest in news technology. If you have any questions, you can send me an email at info@ztechproductions.com. And let me know what your question is, and I can try to answer it on the show. I'm Baby Fleck Jr. with pretty much everyone from Raider Radio in this room right now. And that's ZTech Talk.
Huntley!
You're listening to Radio Radio on HuntleyRadio.com.
Scene one, Apple, take one.
Hi, I'm Carlos, and you're here listening on Radio Radio Media Talk.
It's Media Review.
Media? What did I say?
Media Talk.
Ah!
Scene one, Apple, take two.
Hello, listeners, and welcome to Raider Radio on Huntley Community Radio. You're here with your host, Swarlos, and your co-host...
Molly? Well, we're just going to jump right into it, I guess. So today, we are going to be talking about the show How I Met Your Mother. Again, shocker. March 31st is the season finale. The finale of this whole show.
The series finale?
The series finale.
It's a loss. It's a great loss.
Well, the title says it all. The finale is about how one of the main five characters, Ted Mosby. How one of the main five characters, Ted Mosby, meets his true love. The audience and the rest of the main characters, Marshall Erickson, who is married to Lily Aldrin, with Robin Scherbatsky, who is married to Barney Stinson, have already met the mother. The mother is the bomb diggity. That's street lingo. I'm getting really, really hip with the cool kids, and the mother's really great.
Yeah. The actress for the mother, because we do not even know her name yet in the show, the actress's name is Christina Milioti.
Kristen Milioti.
I'm sorry. But yeah, she's also in The Wolf of Wall Street. If you've already seen that, she was the ex-wife. And yeah, she's actually just a really cool person. She can sing really well because I've already downloaded one of her songs. And yeah, that's all I have to add right now.
Yeah. If you don't know what How I Met Your Mother is, you should. And you should watch it because it's great.
It's great.
Okay. So, hey, Carlos. Hey, audience. Guess what? We're going to talk about Game of Thrones! Game of Thrones is great. Have you watched it?
I have not watched it, and this Molly is trying to get me to get it on the bandwagon with Game of Thrones, but I have not yet joined.
Okay, well, Game of Thrones is a very... it's on HBO, for one thing, and HBO doesn't have... They don't have boundaries, so... But it's great all the same. For those who don't know, Game of Thrones is Neato Burrito. Do you have a sense of what it is, Game of Thrones, by the title?
I'm guessing it's a Game of Thrones.
You're correct! The synopsis is about these families who rule different regions. One of the regions the show focuses on the most is a place called Westeros, which is where, like, the United States is located. And in Westeros, there are seven kingdoms. Are you guys keeping up? Are you guys confused? That's good. It gets a bit more complicated as we go on. These families, Lannister, Targaryen, Stark, Tyrell, and there's a lot more, basically want to rule all of the seven kingdoms. You guys still confused?
Just a bit.
Okay. I'm not a great explainer, but we have a limited amount of time, so I'm getting really excited just talking about it, so let's just move on to what we should talk about. The upcoming season, season 4, which is going to air April 6th on, wink wink, HBO. Do not recommend for kids, by the way. Because there are dragons, and dragons are too cool for you guys. It's just for the cool people. Okay. anyway, season 4 is going to... You should caps lock my voice for effect. It's going to get intense. You get dragons, and you get death, and you get a whole smorgasbord of greatness. And I think what everyone is excited about who watches Game of Thrones is Daenerys Targaryen, who is also known as Khaleesi.
Not a queen, but a Khaleesi.
But a Khaleesi. Yeah, she's the one with the dragons, and she's also great, and yes.
Well, that was our little section on the Game of Thrones. Molly over here can barely keep herself together.
I'm shaking.
But, all right, so obviously this movie has been coming up for quite some time, and the readers to the book have been very, I would say, meticulous on how the movie is going to be brought out. But the author, John Green, will be doing a great job with the movie of The Fault in Our Stars.
Woo!
And, well, I don't remember. Molly, do you remember what the air date is, or the premiere
date? I don't.
Is it, like, June?
June, I think.
It's sometime in June. I know that. June 6th, maybe? Oh, I think it is June 6th. And, so, Molly, have you read the book?
I have, Carlos. Thanks for asking.
You ruined it.
I did.
All right. Molly had a whole joke lined up for this, but she just accidentally improvised it, and it just got ruined.
Oh. It's like even a joke?
Late. It's too late.
We want to start all over?
No. Okay, so basically The Fault in Our Stars, for those who haven't read it, it's like a love story. Well, I wouldn't say a love story. It's more of just like a tragic story about two kids who ended up getting into a relationship about a not-so-great topic of cancer. And there's like really no way to explain it without like rephrasing the whole book. So
I don't think it's a love story.
It's not a love story. I tried to not say that.
I get it.
But yeah.
It's emotional.
It is very emotional. I've talked to several people who cried. It is funny though. That is true.
Yeah.
Yes. Why don't you join us, Emily?
This is our guest, Emily Barron, who just arrived.
Hi, guys. How are you today?
We're good. Yeah, what's your take on The Fault in Our Stars?
Oh, God. Okay. Well, it's been a while since I read it, but it's sad, but then it's funny, and then, like, you just kind of, like, fall for the characters, and then it's just, it kind of makes me hate John Green a little bit. But, like, in a good way.
Yeah.
Because it was a really good book.
Yeah. He's kind of a genius.
Have you guys read other books from him?
Yeah.
I have not. I have yet to start reading Looking for Alaska.
I'm currently reading Looking for Alaska. That's good.
Yeah. Did you read Paper Towns?
No,
but I saw it and...
Amazing.
Okay.
I'm also in the middle of Abundance of Catherines.
I haven't read that one. I've read, like, all the other ones. Except for that one, and there's just something about it. I just look at it, and I'm like, I don't know. I don't know where to start with this.
Well, John Green is pretty great, and the book's pretty great, and I'm kind of hoping that the movie's also great.
I love the two actors, though, that got chosen for The Fault in Our Stars leads,
Ansel Elgort and Shailene Woodley.
Yes.
Both were in Divergent.
And, yeah, it was weird. They were siblings, and now
they're going to be, like, after siblings. But I was just glad that they weren't too many sibling scenes in Divergent, or else that would have just made, like, the whole...
Yeah, it would have kind of ruined
Guys,
it.
Guys, incest is in Game of Thrones.
Oh, God. Molly.
Not for children.
Yeah, but when I first, like, got the book, I had to read it for school, so I didn't know what to expect, really. But like, I remember I was on vacation, and I figured, why not start the reading? Because, you know, school starts in, like, 2 weeks, so might as well start now. And I finished the book in 2 days because I just couldn't put it down. I was so connected to the book, and it was just a really great story. And,
yeah. I don't think I cried when the actual sad part happened. I only, like, get really emotional when the profound parts, like, come into play.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't cry.
I don't know.
I didn't cry. I was just really depressed and on
vacation,
so. I feel like I should
have cried, but I didn't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It just takes you on a roller coaster.
It does.
You're, like, really happy one moment, and you're like, no, this isn't happening. No.
Okay, so moving on to...
Are we on our music selection now?
Sure.
All right. I've been excited for this morning because, after all, today was our morning day for How I Met Your Mother, but I found out some great news that Lana Del Rey is releasing an album on May 1st. I think it's called Ultraviolence. And even though it wasn't completely clear in the article, they did say that Lana Del Rey had surprised them with the release date of May 1st. So get your calendars ready because that day will be coming up soon, and I cannot wait.
I don't listen to Lana Del Rey.
I know, but you should.
I do occasionally. I mean, I should. I'm a music person. But
yeah. I mean, many people know her from the remix of Summertime Sadness, but like, her music is way different than the remix.
Yeah.
And Oh yeah. I've heard some of her other songs. They're good.
They are. Yeah.
I'm just not like an avid listener to her.
I am. I've gone like like deep into Lana Del Rey and seen like all of her undiscovered music, and it's pretty great.
I feel like I should now.
Yeah. I mean, most of her songs aren't like that appropriate for I don't know. It takes a certain taste to listen to Lana Del Rey, but...
And a certain level of maturity.
Yes, there you go.
Well, to get you guys a little insight on what Lana Del Rey sounds like and who she is, here is a song. A song, Carlos, any song.
I guess we should play... Born to Die, just an original from Lana Del Rey, even though the true fans will probably hate me because it's such a, like, old song
by
her. It's been overplayed a little bit, but it's the only one that I can think of that wouldn't, I don't know, cross any boundaries, so.
Hold on.
Here you go.
I have one. My Spotify playlist.
What about that one Great Gatsby song from...
Oh, Young and Beautiful. Well,
there's that. What about Dark Paradise?
Oh, I like that one, yes. Never mind, we are now playing Dark Paradise by Lana Del Rey. So I hope you enjoy our little inside look on LDR.
Standing for Lana Del Rey.
I was trying to be cool, Molly. Come on. Let me do this.
You can't be hip and down like me.
Play it, and there's no remedy for me.
All right. Well, I guess that's all for our show today on Media Review. Thank you for joining.
And
thank you, Emily, for stepping in.
You're welcome.
I am one of your hosts, Molly.
And for today, I'm Swarlos. Goodbye.
Raider Radio is the new program on Huntley Community Radio, created for and by Huntley High School students. Catch the sound for all the latest music and the talk for topics you don't want to miss.